Welcome dear students, I welcome you for the part 3 of our lesson Public Facility and My School. Before this we have discussed few subtopics of the lesson. So today we will be continuing the same lesson with more subtopics. So let's begin. So first topic that we will be discussing about is community and school. As the school is part of the society, so there is a relation between school and community. So they are interrelated with each other. Means school can help the community the same way the community or the society or the people can also help in the growth of school. For example, there are many people who help in the development of the school. So these people can be like past students of the same school, or the artists, then sports persons, industrialists, and so many type of people like scientists and so many. So these people always help the school. This, how they help the school, they can help by different ways. Like they can help in giving the assistant money to the school. Especially there are many schools in our country which required really the help, the financial help. We are lucky that you are learning in one of the best schools where the all facilities are available. But in many areas where the facilities are not available, especially in rural areas where there are less facilities. So these students are not getting sufficient facility they required. For that reason, people help the school management they help, so that it will be beneficial to the society itself. Okay, so you must have read about news that comes that this person has given this much donation, he has given books to the school, library they have donated something, they have donated some uniforms to students, like this. So it means even people of the society also help the school. The same way the school also can help the society, because it is a part of the society only. Like you must have seen before many a time in this, the school has helped many a way. Like cleaning the garbage, then road shows, then awareness about many things. So the school also can be helpful to the society, the area where it is situated. It can help to get the village clean. It can help the poor people or those who are not getting education to get education. If the people are not able to pay the fees, the school can give some concession, or they can be given free admission to such students. So there are many ways the school can help the society. Okay, so they are interrelated with each other. So the society required the help of school, and school also required the help of society. So each other's help and cooperation is important for the development of the student or the development of the society. So the school can be given like facilities for the playground, or the sports instruments can be donated to students. Even a donation or the money or the help can be given for the library of a school. like some books can be donated so that the student can read those books, especially in the rural areas where it is actually required. So even for the different laboratories, like there are no lab, science lab, chemistry labs and computer labs, so money or the people can be helpful in the giving assistance to the students in providing these facilities that we are discussing now. Then comes the next important point of our lesson, that is parents teachers meeting. You know about this, like this is the meeting between parents of the school and teachers of the school. We have already taken and we are in the process to take this parent teachers meeting. So before this we have number of parents teachers meeting, and what are the benefits of such parents meeting, what will be the advantage of such meetings. So these parents and teachers meeting is required, it is beneficial to development of the child, because the parent should know how the child is getting progress, how are his results. Okay, so the meetings will help the parents to know about the progress of the child. Then there will be interaction between parents and teachers. So suppose the teacher may want to talk something about the child with the parents, or the same way parents also can be talking, they require to talk with the teachers for the development of the child. So the interaction is possible when the meeting of these two groups are taken. Even the parents can suggest few things about the progress of the child as well as the progress of the school. The same way the teacher also can suggest few things for the development of particular child. So information sharing is also possible. So parents teachers is meeting is very necessary for the development of child. Like even parents can also be helpful to school. Like there are so many parents who have the abilities to teach the children, even they can share the information with the children, and they can make the children to learn new things. Okay, so the parents also can be the part of, we can say, learning. Here is an example, like parent is teaching music, a parent conducts a drill. The same way as I told you, the school also can be helpful to the society, like the children are cleaning the village. There are a number of ways through which a school can help, a student can help to the society. Then we have next important part of the lesson, that is Mata Palak Sangha. What is this? So Mata Palak Sangha, as I was telling you about parent teacher meeting, where father or mother or any one of the guardian can take part in the meeting. But the government has made such arrangement that there are Mata Palak Sangha, where the mother parent is given the permission to attend the meeting regarding the development of the child. So this is Mata Palak Sangha, where the mother is an integral part of the meeting. So why the mother is integral part of the meeting? Because most of the time is spent with the child by a mother. Because mother spend lot of child time with that child. As many of can be housewives, so they are getting more time to spend with their children. So if we are talking with the mother, that can be beneficial for the child. So Mata Palak Sangha is also a concept where mother parents are allowed to participate in the discussion or the meetings. Then next is Parent Teacher Association. It is somewhat different from the first one, earlier one, that is Parent Teachers Meeting. PTA is different from Parent Teachers Meeting. How? Because in PTA, the selective representatives are allowed to attend the meeting. Okay, as every parent cannot be the part of the meeting always, for that reason, government has made the arrangement of Parents Teacher Association, that is PTA. That is compulsory in every school. In our school also we have PTA. So what are the differences between PTA and the normal meeting? So PTA are the representative selected from the parents only. For this reason, particular procedure is followed. Like all the parents are informed that those who are interested to be a part of the PTA, Parents Teacher Association, they can nominate or they can stand for the elections. And properly the elections or the lucky draw system is given and the parents are selected from the group of parents. And they work as a representative for a class. Okay. And these people, suppose it can be one parent from each class, like suppose it is class first. So there will be one representative from all the students or the parents of learning, parents who are getting learnt in the first standard. So he will be representative from the parent side. The same way there will be one representative from the teacher side. So that will be representative of a teacher. Teacher side will be one representative, parent side one representative. This way this association is created. And what is the function of this association? Suppose important decisions are to be taken. So always parents cannot be called or they don't have time or certain responsibilities. So Parents Teachers Association PTA meetings are arranged and in PTA meetings some decisions are taken. And it is considered that this decision is taken on the behalf of parents as well as teachers. Okay, so according to rule, according to law, this happens. So it is a discussion, it gives a platform to parents, teachers, representative to share their ideas, to take new decisions before taking or any making a rule. So we have this Parent Teacher Association in the school, then we have Mata Palak Sangha and of course Parent Teachers Meeting. These are the platforms which give help or they will be helpful to the parents as well as teachers for the development of a child. And parents should take active part in such meetings which are arranged for the development of the child. Okay, for that reason we have this system implemented. And this all organization, purpose of this all organization is to have a good interaction with each other so that the development of the child happens. Okay, so we have discussed almost whole lesson and we have discussed how the public facilities are important, then what is the role of government in public facilities and how the people should use the public facilities. The people should use the public facility responsibly. Means, though we are getting the public facilities, the public facilities should be used very properly. There should not be wastage or misuse of what we call the government property or the public facilities, so that everyone in the society gets the public facility properly. So it is the responsibility of every citizen to use the public facilities very properly so that everyone is getting beneficial. For example, many time we see that water is supplied in our houses. If the people are using the water sparingly, they are not doing the wastage of water, that is going to be helpful to the people only, isn't it? So people should use the public facility responsibly so that it will be beneficial to every person in the society. Not only the person who is living, but it will be beneficial to the future generation also. And then we have discussed about the importance of school and education system for the development of a country. And the schemes which are organized by the government for the development of the schools or all education, like we have Right to Education Act 2009. So that act is also important for you to study. And how the school has the responsibility towards the society, as well as the society has the responsibility towards the school. Okay, so still if you have any doubts, you can ask me. You are free to ask me your doubts so that your doubts will be cleared.